One of these changes is found in the weather behavior, which has created new life forms coexisting with nature. But in current times, we have observed how torrential rains, drought, and heat waves provoke landslides and floods, which are damaging great portions of mankind. Today, more energy is needed because of the industrial development of modern times. Industry and means of transportation produce even more toxic fumes associated with the greenhouse effect, and this speeds global warming and, in the end, climate change. In our country, we witness climate change manifest in the melting of glaciers frequently, and the intensity of El Niño current, which affects the villagers in the most impoverished areas located in the high Andes region. The government has been implementing policies for the past 10 years, which aim to strengthen the capabilities to respond efficiently to the impact of climate change. The National Strategy of Climate Change was approved in 2003, which has provided the guidelines to follow in implementing national programs and projects with the support of international cooperation. In 2005, the Program for Strengthening National Capabilities and Resource Management was completed in order to face the problems related to the climate change and air quality, PROCLIM. Activities were carried out in the regions of Junin and Piura. The second National Communication of Peru for Climate Change was implemented in 2006, and it's carried out in the basin of the Santa River in the Ancash region and in the Mayo River in the San Martin region. The results sought by this intervention will allow a national adaptation strategy, as well as other mitigation, focused upon reducing the fumes causing the greenhouse effect. By creating the Ministry of Environment in May 2008, new opportunities were generated for the country in order to develop the programs and projects needed to face climate change. Piura is rich in natural resources, but is vulnerable to climate change in the forms of El Niño and La Niña phenomena. Result, disturbed cattle farming and agriculture, particularly in the impoverished areas.
Nosotros estamos ahora abocados a lo que es la definición de una estrategia regional de cambio climático, pero articulada a la estrategia de lo que es la diversidad biológica y también la lucha contra la desertificación y sequía.
Among the activities for adapting to climate change which are carried out by the regional government of Piura and with the cooperation of international organizations such as GTZ, ITDG and Nature and Culture, we can point out the Paramona Conservation. These extensive mist forests, located at an altitude of 2,000 to 3,000 meters, are where several rivers are naturally created. The Paramona captures the rains and mist, and then the water is transferred to the coast by rivers and underground. Their destruction would aggravate the drought. The local authorities, teachers, and ronderos in the area are the present promoters of adapting technologies such as the construction of miniature reservoirs, irrigation improvement, handling and conservation of the land, organic fertilizers, and forest production. Recovery of coffee harvesting is taking place in Canchaque, Huancabamba, where the heat has caused numbers to decrease from 800 to 200 pounds per hectare. The use of organic pesticides, agroforestry, and technical irrigation is being promoted. In the mid-Piura River region, the irrigation of lime, cotton, and corn has been improved, and less water is being used. Black-eyed bean farming is encouraged, and this requires little water. It improves the ground, and it's a commercial commodity. Subterranean water is obtained by using electric wells, and this allows a second rice crop per year. Other adjustments seek to protect the vast dry forests and pastures in Piura. Campesinos are no longer cutting down the algarroba trees. They use their flowers for the honey. The young leaves and fruit are then mixed with pasture feed for their rams and goats. Only very few branches are used now as firewood. Due to the drought and the cold spells which have taken place in our mountain range during the past 12 years, the government has developed 110,000 water reservoirs, together with over 3,000 kilometers of waterworks. The land has improved thanks to reforestation using eucalyptus, pine, mole, quinoa, cypress, tara, aliso, and casuarina. In addition, they are encouraging the irrigation of 600,000 hectares and the planting of over 550 million tree seedlings throughout 370,000 hectares of deforested Andean land. Furthermore, the largest program for ovine, bovine, and camelid protection was performed in the highland communities by building 18,000 sheds with cement, wood, and calamine as protection against snow, frost, and extreme hailstorms. This is the Callejón de Huaylas in the high basin of the River Santa, a critical zone due to glacial loss. In the past 30 years, global warming has reduced up to 30% of the ice, which covers nearly 112 square kilometers. In the Pastoruri snowcaps, there's no longer a snow layer. To the left of the river, in the Cordillera Negra, the situation is even more complex. There's no ice, snow, or rain, and very little water is available from the underground. The organization Soluciones Prácticas, ITDG, has developed measures to adapt to climate change on both sides, the most important one being improvements in the usage of the limited water supply.
Nosotros aquí tenemos dos canales que vienen de la Laguna de Yanganuco y que vienen también del Nevado Guandoy. Entonces aquí nosotros regamos por turno. Y aquí a Huaya solamente le toca todos los domingos. Si el domingo no has regado el agua, ya fuiste porque tienes que esperar tu turno hasta la próxima semana.
To the other side of the river, in the Cordillera Negra, a technical irrigation module has been installed in the plot of Pablo Huertas in the district of Chuplui. And consequently, his avocado and corn crops have improved. Southern Cusco is particularly fragile because of the threat from Sicuani in Alto Vicanota, where we can find the Kisini community and where the snow-capped Apu Quexcra rises and runs into the river Quexcra. In this puna, at an altitude of over 4,500 meters, life is tough. There are no roads, and on the limited agricultural land, only the native potato, sparse grass, alpacas, and the vicuñas flourish. In this part of the country, water is very scarce most of the year. The Innovative Agrarian Institute, INIA, with the support of international sponsors, has developed and reproduced technologies to improve and adapt native potato farming techniques. Achievements include establishing a school and training approximately 80 farmers, both men and women, to become experts, or camayocs, in native potato farming.
En tanto que hemos aprendido sembrando la papa, cultivar más que todo con abonos orgánicos. Después utilizamos más que todo con para plaguicida. Estamos utilizando lo que es con hierbas amargas y también el abono foliar para follaje de la papa. Y eso hemos aprendido más que todo.